Chris Johnson will kick off for Auburn. Kerry Goode, number 35, and Bobby Humphrey, the All-American, number 26, deep for Alabama. And this is Goode, who will down it in the end zone. And Humphrey moves the chain as he gets past the 30-yard line for an 11-yard gain on the pitch sweep, which is the bread and butter of the Alabama offense. Humphrey in motion. Heavy rush. And Don just gets rid of the football. Derek Thomas, who has 15 sacks this year, and co-captain Randy Rockwell. On third down and 5, the pass to Donaldson is incomplete. Now the Auburn fans try to crank up the noise to distract Dunn as he approaches third and 9. And he gives to Humphrey on the draw, and Humphrey gets a big play for Alabama to get them out of the shadow of their own goal line and pick up the second Crimson Tide first down of the game. That die, 3-3 versus Alabama as a head coach at Auburn. He was an assistant coach under Bear Bryant for 9 years. So this is his 16th visit to Legion Field for this game. Dunn completes it down the middle. Number 40 with the football is Allen. And Bill Curry chose him as a captain for today's game, saying that his leadership and his help to Bobby Humphrey have been exemplary. Now, on third down, down the middle to number 85, the tight end Howard Cross. And Cross tries to lean forward to move the chain.
Hey, listen, they win this game, they go to the Sugar Bowl possibly. You lose, you drop back into fourth place.
They agree with you. I'm not sure I wouldn't kick the football myself. Fourth and inches for Alabama. Full house backfield. Number 40 is Bo Wright. I still think I might have kicked it.
Well, I tell you what, he didn't get it, so everybody in the stadium is going to agree with you now, and they'll second guess Bill Curry.
No, Pat won't have to.
He'll love it.
He'll be the beneficiary. He'll keep his mouth shut. Big play from the middle of the Alabama defensive line as number 55, Derek Thomas, bolted across from his linebacker position. Dunn going to throw from near his goal line. Releases over the middle and gets it to number 85, Howard Cross. And that was dangerous. There was a defender between Dunn and Cross.
Last 5 games, Jim, a total of 12 points, as you mentioned. And over the last 6 years, these two teams have split.
7-yard gain on the pass to Cross. Ball now at the 19. Humphrey, pitch sweep, good block. Out near the 30-yard line. Another Alabama first down. Now it is third down 9 for Dunn. And this one is picked off. Went down the middle one too many times. Kurt Crane, number 39, was there with Cross all the way, and that pass should not have been thrown.
He got a Heisman Trophy vote.
Yes, that's right. Stacy Danley on first down, sweeping to the right, has a pickup of about 7. Now Jeff Berger brings Auburn back to the line of scrimmage on third down 2 and gives inside to Reggie Ware. And Ware is at the 30 and just across, and that will be a first down for Auburn. Thomas and Gilbert are juniors. Well, Alabama can look forward to another year of their big play. On third down, Berger. The pass is intercepted. Intercepted. Number 9, Mike Smith with the pickoff for Alabama. Third down. They need about 6 for the first down. Battle and Whitehurst, the receivers. Dunn gets away. And now is dropped. Donaldson gets away and gets out near the 35-yard line. Auburn starts with the football to begin the second quarter. First down at its 35-yard line. Berger throws to Reggie Ware, and he's got a lot of room. Across midfield to the 48-yard line of Alabama. It is third down now as Berger looks downfield. Complete to Donaldson. He is dropped short of the first down. Shulman aiming for the sideline. Jelks lets it go. The ball bounces back to midfield and is downed at the 7-yard line. And breaking up through the middle this time is Wright. On second down and 8, Dunn whirls and keeps it. And is able to wade across the 35 to about the 37. Third down, 7 yards to go. Dunn drops straight back, good throw. And the first down into Auburn territory at the 45-yard line. Marco Battle on the receiving end. But Auburn wasn't able to take advantage of that field position A. On third down here, Humphrey has the football and pounds forward toward the chain, but I think he's going to be short again. Now elects to try for a 53-yard field goal. Phillip Boyle will be the kicker, 13 of 19 on the year, 1 of 4 from outside 50 yards. Abney gets the hold down. Doyle's kick is no good. Hit the left upright and went down. And again, a reversal for Alabama and a field position edge for Auburn.
Alabama shows blitz. Here they come now. Backside.
A lot of people coming. Derek Thomas with the block. Ball goes out of bounds, and Alabama will have it at the Auburn 10-yard line. Auburn shifting to the bottom side of your screen. Good goes in motion to the top. That's where Alabama goes. Humphrey is dropped at about the 1.
They also brought in Doug Allen at fullback. He's the better blocker of the two fullbacks. 46. Got them both in. They've got Allen and Wright in there, both fullbacks.
Done. Too high. With the NFL today at 12:30 Eastern Time. That's Sunday on CBS 4. Third down for Auburn. Berger in his end zone. Good release. The catch by Danley, the ball at the 12-yard line, and a first down for Auburn.
You know, they really had to get him to settle down, be more disciplined, stay at home.
Berger wants to go downfield deep, and Lawyer Tillman is there. The flag is down, and we'll have to wait to see if that's offensive interference, but I think it probably was a push by Gene Jelks. And the call is a personal foul against Jelks, and Tillman had been quiet up to that point. He, like Derek Thomas, though, is a big play player who can break up a game like this. And there's Derek Thomas again, dumping Berger beyond the 35-yard line.
And holding against the offense, it was a live ball foul and it's declined. We had a dead ball foul, personal foul against Alabama. It's a first down.
That's got to drive Bill Curry mildly crazy at this point. Danley breaks through a hole and is down to the 5-yard line. Auburn has first down, goal to go at the 5-yard line. Harry Mose, touchdown. Spread formation for Alabama. 3 wide receivers to the bottom of your screen. Dunn drops back. Kurt Crane. Humphrey with the tackle.
Pretty good lick by Humphrey, too.
And that's the end of the first half. With the score, Auburn 7, Alabama nothing. Fullback, Reggie Ware, close to a first down, and he may have it. And then went 99 yards on the strength of the 44-yard pass to Tillman. 2 big 15-yard penalties against Alabama. And here is Danley breaking into the secondary and fumbling the ball. And Alabama has it. If, in fact, they're going to be given credit for the recovery.
One official says yes.
Draw play is smelled out and stopped for a loss. Benji Rowland, the nose guard, stayed home all the way. First down now for Berger and the Tigers, and Berger drops back. Gets away from Thomas. Can't get away from the second man, number 51, Tommy Cole.
Thomas says his favorite number is 12. He wants to be near it all day.
Draw play. Danley. Couldn't get away from number 9 out there. Well, no, a 7-yard pickup. Could have been second and 14. It's now 3rd and 7. They try to draw again. Derek Thomas has Danley. Danley tries to make it to the chain, and he got very close. 2nd down 6. Ware. 1st down. Finally knocked out of bounds across midfield at the Alabama 48.
See, the time left in the ballgame is not the key. The time of possession is the key. Auburn's had the ball a long time, and the Alabama defense is tired. They need a rest. Here comes Thomas.
And Berger overthrows.
And then he looks at his feet almost to say, I know you're there, Derek.
Alabama 1st and 10 from the 20. Dunn able to release the ball, and the incompletion saves Alabama some yardage.
I'm neutral myself.
3 yards to go for the first down. Bobby Humphrey has it as he gets across the 45 to about the 47. You're particularly heartened by the choice of Kerry Goode because he's been a great citizen during his years at Alabama. On 3rd down 6, Dunn is in trouble and is down at his own 40-yard line. Kurt Crane was there early. And the Skins with strong memories of last season's NFC Championship game when the Giants kept them from going to the Super Bowl. Now the first-place Skins have a big chance for revenge. It all starts with the NFL today at 12:30 Eastern Time Sunday. Berger on 3rd down gets out of trouble momentarily and then is dragged down. Derek Thomas again, one of the men there to tackle Berger. And Auburn lines up in a hurry to punt it away. Schulman from inside his 10 gets this one off, but it's a low kick. And Jelks brings it back to about the 47 before a wallop is put on him by Elton Billingsley. Good in motion to the bottom. Good protection for Dunn. Now he breaks out. Threw it into a crowd. The Tigers are 4 for 11 on 3rd downs in the game. Berger complete. 1st down yardage and out of bounds at the 29. Second catch of the game for Lawyer Tillman. And got him a singleton on Tillman. Sack. Derek Thomas again, along with number 92, Darrell Whetstone, in the 52nd meeting between the Auburn Tigers and the Alabama Crimson Tide. Auburn with the football at its own 20-yard line. Draw play. And number 32, Stacy Danley, breaks out to about the 35. 3rd down 3. Reggie Ware. Close. Dragged down right at about the chain. This will be a critical measurement. The ball is at the 39 of Auburn. Ware. All the way to the 40-yard line. Mike Smith makes the stop, flag down on the play. But this is a big break for the Tide.
Danger against the offense, just 6 men on the line of scrimmage.
Coming into this ball game, I was sure that we'd see David Smith. They were talking about him the way that Coach Curry talked about him in his office yesterday and the day before. He is amazed that Smith came back with that collarbone injury and is throwing very well.
You saw Jeff Dunn there slapping his hand. On 3rd down, Berger throws complete to Donaldson. And again, Auburn overcomes the penalty.
Everybody's coming.
Tillman across the 40 to the 39-yard line. The chain was right at the 40 by about a half a yard. Tillman got the 1st down.
Oh, what a hit.
Reggie Ware didn't get it. Now Auburn lines up to try a 47-yard field goal. Win Lyle is the kicker. The hold is good. The kick is up. Wide to the right. Alabama Alabama dodges the bullet. 9 minutes, 7 seconds left. Humphrey. 12-yard gain. Kevin Porter made the stop for Auburn. Jeff Dunn, Billy Ray, Vince Sutton. Those three among the most heavily recruited quarterbacks in the country over the past few years. Nobody cared much about David Smith. Third down, 4. Plenty of room if he wants to run it. He throws short. Berger, 14 of 18 in the game. He's been brilliant in the second half.
First down.
Stacy Danley. That's been the problem for Alabama in the second half. And again, Berger has been at the heart of that. As you said, the curator of the clock.
Another third down situation. Alabama's got to capitalize on these if they want a shot.
The chain is at the 45. Incomplete, but a flag down.
Holding on the defense.
It all starts with the NFL today at 12:30 Sunday. Second down, breaking through is Danley. Another big play by the freshman tailback, and it'll be a first down on Auburn at the Alabama 35. Danley again. All the way down to the 12-yard line. Alabama beginning to look a little disheartened. He admits that it was not the most comfortable move in the world for him to go to a passing offense. But he did it because he had the players to do it. Reggie Ware is stopped. A field goal try coming up for Wynn Lyle. And this will be a short one. 23 yards. He missed earlier from 47. The kick is up. It's 10-0 Auburn. So a little bit of insurance for the Auburn Tigers.
I've seen business ventures split, families broken up because of these games.
I think you and I are going to be able to remain friends. On second down, Smith throws down the middle. Knocked loose.
Ball game.
Do it.
Ball game. It's over.
A final disheartening blow to Alabama. Berger puts his knee down, and that'll do it. 7-4 for Alabama. 9-1-1 for Auburn. Take a look again at the final score of today's 52nd meeting between Auburn and Alabama.